Holland, and that is Jan Kuiper of... No, it's not, it's Henk Lubberding of Holland. 106 on the far right of the course. Come round here now towards Woodcote Crossroads. The Italians again forcing the pressure here. This time the rider doing the pressurising is Mascarelli of Italy. Zoetemelk from Holland taking up the chase. Kelly there in fourth place. And how cleverly he's using the tactics of the Dutch and the Italians to stay in contact with the leaders.
The strength of Zoetemelk for 36 years of age, what an amazing man he is. Every time these races are over 150 miles duration, he comes into his own. He's never actually won this world title. I wonder if today he could just get that, what he's after. Up at the front there, forcing the pace, but Sean Kelly, ever a tentative of all the moves. This is the man, the favourite for this race. Nobody wants to let anybody go at all, and that is a little Spanish rider that is in the lead now. 6 hours, 20 minutes, 47 seconds on the clock there.
And I think that Spanish rider who's joined Kuiper at the front is Marino Lageretta from Spain, and these two riders now trying desperately to open up the gap. Kuiper, I think, will welcome this Spaniard because neither of them are great sprint finishers, and Kuiper may well still provide the strength at the end. But look at the battle on the mountain now as we're coming up. Coming round the corner now, I'm sure this is Ismael, this is Marino Lageretta from Spain, followed there by Kuiper, and the big bunch now swinging also into the paddock, heading up for the bell. Almost 7 hours of cycling. On the right here is Klaus-Peter Thal of Germany in the green jersey, Sean Kelly. Ahead of Kelly, Jan Raas, and in front of Jan Raas, Sven Ocker Nielsen leading this group. The Spanish rider, and this will be the biggest surprise of any World Championships if Spain take this title. There's the bell. Here comes Kuiper. There's the main field. Sean Kelly has got to bridge this gap now, Hugh.
Yes, very dangerous, but I think the fact that the Spaniard has got in the lead is going to play into the hands of Kelly, because it means that the chasers have now got to fetch him back, because they were hoping that Henk Kuiper was the man that was favourite to win, so the Dutch will have to take up the chase again. What a turn-up this would be if Lageretti of Spain could win. Forcing his way over the top of this climb now, with just over 9 miles to go to the finish of this World Professional Road Race Championship. Sean Kelly in a very good position indeed at the front of the bunch, because the onus is on the big teams to chase this Spaniard who's away up the front.
Now the wait, and Sean Kelly, it is, of Ireland in second place. He's joined Henk Kuiper. And this is marvellous now. The people in the grandstand who are watching television too have seen this, and they now know that Sean Kelly has a chance of a gold medal, Hugh.
Indeed, he's the best sprinter out of this trio that are away. The only thing that concerns me is Kuiper will probably sit in his wheel. Kelly will be totally committed. I hope he doesn't exhaust himself if the bunch catches them up. So the whole bunch look to have joined up again, so it means that Kelly has been caught back. So the onus now on Lageretta out at the front, but I can't see him keeping away like this, because the bunch is really boring down on him, and Kelly will be in the middle of that field now being dragged along. I myself, not wanting to appear biased, I'm much pleased the fact that he's in there with the shelter of the Italians and the Dutch who are going to carry him.
And the Italians, I think, are now feeling the pressure of trying to keep Cerrone in the action. That was Mascarelli, Ginetti, and both those riders look extremely tired there as they swung round Strettington going through. And it looks as though it's going to be all over here. They've caught Lageretta, and Kelly goes again, this time sitting on the wheel of Rennie Martins of Belgium. So Martins of Belgium goes. He finds he's got Sean Kelly on his wheel, and Cerrone in third place. So there is nobody in this race doesn't realise the value and the experience of Sean Kelly now as one of the best riders in the world. All we want to see now is over these next four miles, Sean Kelly to prove it to us all, Hugh.
They're all very anxious indeed, because that green jersey up the front, that man has won so many sprints this year, they're all anxious to try and get rid of him. And of course, on the front there, guarding him is Rennie Martins, who won the Tour of Flanders this year, another single day specialist, but another man hovering there with his eyes on this title in fifth spot. The man in the white jersey, of course, is Phil Anderson.
Come through the trees. Holland setting this pace. Bell Scholten on the front. Henk Kuiper also there. Jan Raas in fourth place. Ginetti in third place in that blue jersey. Jonathan Bowyer there, fifth in the World Championships. Let us not forget this, in 1980 in Solange.
This can play into Kelly's hands. The fact that the tempo goes up at the front from a teammate will stop people trying to jump away. We'll see as they come out of the trees whether he is still at the front. Yet here at the...
Like this in Britain, every time the spectators catch a glimpse of the television monitors and they see that green jersey, they just let out an enormous cheer, because they believe that Sean Kelly will walk away with his title. Kelly surely will not allow this to go. Lagiretta trying again, Jonathan Bowyer joining him. So Lagiretta of Spain and Bowyer of the USA, neither nation having won the world title before. Lagiretta glances over his shoulder, and how on earth he's finding the strength now to go for home on this final lap when he was away for the previous lap, I really don't know. But Bowyer goes clear, and Bowyer must not be left alone, because he was fifth in the world title on a very, very difficult course in Solange two years ago.
Sean Kelly realising the danger, surging to the front. So are the Dutchman, but look at Jonathan Bowyer. He's attacking after almost 169 miles. He realises that the end is in sight. He would be the first American to ever win this world title, but the Dutch realise the danger. They're trying to close the gap. Sean Kelly very well placed there. He's on the wheel at the moment of Giuseppe Cerone, the man who could possibly dislodge him in a sprint finish. So the big sprinter starting to mass at the front, but they've got to catch that Lagiretta, and Jonathan Bowyer, of course, he's the man who's going away. He's taken the chance. This is what can happen at the end.
Well, 65,000 people here are being treated to a most extraordinary finish of the World Championship in Goodwood. Bowyer changes gear, he glances over his shoulder, he knows he can still do it. And Greg LeMond of the United States comes as well. Now, really, LeMond should not be doing this, because he's bringing with him all the other riders towards his teammate. And one of those riders is Sean Kelly. Round the corner comes Jonathan Bowyer, and just behind him comes the whole field. Bowyer now heading up to the finish. It's agonising, but this, and right past it goes Giuseppe Cerone. Cerone is going to take the world title. This is a tremendous finish for Italy, and look at the speed of him now. Cerone washes by Bowyer as he comes up the line and tucks right in with the crowd. Cerone of Italy, and the Italians are going absolutely mad here on the line as they are about to hit the line now. Giuseppe Cerone has won the world title. He throws kisses to the crowd, and in second place there goes Jonathan Bowyer, and I think Sean Kelly was third with a bronze medal. Coming round this corner now, the figure of Jonathan Bowyer, who so nearly took this world title. He led out, and he goes on now, thinking that just a matter of 150 yards separates him from a gold medal. And then on his shoulder went Giuseppe Cerone, and just behind him there was Greg LeMond, the junior world champion just a couple of years ago. Cerone tried hard to win this title last year. In fact, he took the silver medal behind Freddie Mertens of Belgium. Cerone wasn't going to make a mistake this time. He swung over to the right of the road. He glanced over his shoulder. He was riding now like a man possessed. Italy have waited long enough for this world title, and they will be absolutely delighted. But what a finish this has been for the English-speaking nations, because just like in the Tour de France, where Phil Anderson and Sean Kelly were among the prize and leaders all the time, Cerone comes over the line and kisses the crowd. So the proud moment in the life of Giuseppe Cerone after three second places in the last 4 years for Italy. This time he's landed for his country the world professional crown. He shakes hands there with Greg LeMond in second place, and there he is, Giuseppe Cerone. He's a pin-up boy in Italy, they call him Beppe, and he's finally come home with the goods. He was second last year in the World Championships in Prague. And now the jersey of a world champion, for 1 year hence he can ride everywhere in the rainbow colours of the jersey of the 1982 champion of the world.